Hello guys and welcome back to our Craze. So today I shall be unboxing and giving you guys an overview of this TVS riding cloud. So without any further delay, let's get started with the video. So guys, starting up with TVS recently launched a subdivision of the TVS Performance Gear and their Motor Soul 2019. Which is pretty much a good initiative taken by TVS. Now what comes under the performance gear is two divisions. One is the riding gears, the other one is urban wear. Under riding gears you have helmets, riding jackets, riding pants, riding boots as well as riding gloves. Under urban wear you have t-shirts, caps, sunglasses, urban shoes and backpacks. So most of the items on their performance gear list is not yet in stock. They have just written as coming soon. And when I got in touch with one of the TVS Performance Gear executives, they had told that they're running some stock issues, most probably by Jan 2020, it'll all be in stock. But luckily I received a call a few days back telling that the TVS riding gloves is back in stock, and I went ahead and ordered one for myself for daily riding. And I received this product in just 2 days. Yeah, no other way other than ordering it on the TVS Performance Gear website. I'll be dropping their link on the description, you guys can check it out. So I just received the product, and this authenticity of TVS as it written TVS genuine products, which you usually see on TVS spare parts. Now let's go ahead and unbox this and see what we get in. So guys, this is the product and this is how the packaging looks like. It's written as 500 grams. I don't know how well it is. You have the TVS authenticity here as well as you have the genuine products, the sticker which you usually get on the spare parts. So the packaging is pretty much fine, and they shipped it through DTTC and it took like 2 to 3 days. So you have no chances of fake products because it's only available on the Performance Gear store, and moreover we have this TVS genuine product packaging, so pretty much genuine. So let's go ahead and unbox this. So this is a box which we get in, and this is some paperwork again which shows the bill. Let's keep that aside, and this is how the box looks like. Again, it's this TVS company genuine parts box. I usually see air filters and other parts in this box, but never mind, let's just open and see what we get inside this box. So yeah guys, this is how it looks like. It comes in this plastic packaging, a shrink packaging, and the MRP of this glove is 1600. So much I paid for it. So let's open this plastic bag and see what we get inside and whether these gloves fit me perfectly. Oh, it's actually a Ziploc bag, not bad. So you have this TVS Racing, the card. Again, never mind. So my first initial impression is it looks like a leather gloves, but no, it's not a leather gloves. It's not a pure leather gloves, to be frank, and you have, again, I have this TVS Racing touching on. Now the only thing which I was disappointed was there was no options regarding the gloves. This was the only gloves which was available, and there is no other alternative other than this, the TVS Performance Gear division for gloves, and you get only in one color, that is black. You don't have red or any other color which could match your bike, so this is pretty much the only color which we get. But according to the size chart, my size was L, so let's see whether the size chart is accurate and whether it fits my hand. Let me just try it on. The fitting is pretty much accurate. It's on dot how I thought it would be, and that's how it is. And since I'm thin, it's a bit loose out here, but never mind, that's how it is. But the fitting is pretty much good. You can move all your fingers, and according to the size chart, the size is pretty much accurate. So this is how the riding gloves looks like. It looks pretty dope. In fact, it'll suit my bike, the TVS RR310, Apache RR310. Again, it has this TVS Racing gear. So it pretty much looks like most other gloves. There's nothing unique about it, but the only good thing is that you can use your touch for the mobile, and they have something cool on this. It is this. I'll just try focusing the camera so you guys can see. Okay, the camera is not capable enough to capture, but as you guys can see, there's some kind of squeezy kind of thing out here which is used to clear your visor lens. I don't know how well it works, but I'll be dropping down a user review after some time. It's a breathable glass. I haven't mentioned whether it's rainproof or anything, but I would recommend not to use it in the rain. Well, let's see. I'll head up to my motorcycle and let's see how well these gloves perform. So now let's get started with the review. I have the gloves here. I'll put on it. I'm going to test it on this piece, the RR310, which I use it for daily purpose. So I'm going to wear this and get started with the riding and let you guys know how well these gloves perform. So starting off with, these gloves are pretty much comfortable. My initial impressions, they are made up of a very good quality. Yeah, the leather feeling in it, it's made up of PU leather. But yeah, I'd used it for a whole day before I shot this review because I don't want to give my initial impression, because sometimes initial impressions might be wrong. So I used it for one whole day in city traffic and open highways and various other conditions. So now coming back to the topic, there's good amount of ventilation in the gloves. These three fingers, your four middle as well as your ring finger, has ventilation. So there's good amount of air which rushes through these ventilation ports, and kind of you don't sweat inside. But yes, that doesn't mean that you don't completely sweat in the afternoons where there's good amount of sun and it's extremely hot. So that point of time, if you're in bumper to bumper traffic, of course you start to sweat, but that's completely manageable. It's not something which is so annoying that you have to remove your gloves and throw it away. It's nothing like that. Now coming back to the comfort, I experienced a bit of pooky kind of thing on my ring finger when I used to press the clutch. These ventilation ports, which is made up of a bit of hard plastic, which kind of gives protection as well, that tends to kind of poke into your ring finger. I don't know it's whether only for me or for all the gloves, but I guess that's manageable. Everything in you will kind of bite and you'll get used to it as time passes by, so that's completely fine. So guys, coming to the design, in fact it looks good, but since I'm thin, this kind of it's too loose, but it's fine for people who are like proper or a bit fat. It's completely fine, but there's a disadvantage for people who are thin. It has a good covering. You again have the TVS Racing branding here, and this squishy kind of thing is claimed by TVS that you can clean your visor, but I don't understand the point of it because these cannot be used in rain. So yeah, they haven't mentioned anything as such on the website that whether it's waterproof or something. But when you see here, the tag which you get, when I read through that, it was shown that you shouldn't wash it, you shouldn't dry clean it, you shouldn't iron it, and various other things. Since it's leather, it kind of gets spoiled. So I don't understand the point of this squishy thing on both your four fingers. They claim that you can clean your visor with it. Obviously, you need to clean your visor when there's a water or something which is there and which is kind of hindering you to, from seeing the road. But unfortunately, you cannot use a gloves in rain, so I completely don't get the point of the squishy thing. So never mind if someone knows what is the reason behind it, because I never clean my visor with no lubrication. It needs minimum of water for lubrication. And while you're riding, the only thing which hinders you from your which hinders your visor from seeing is rainwater or the droplets of the rain. But obviously you're not going to use these gloves in rain, like why would you need this? I completely don't understand the point of that. Now coming to the main point, protection. There's good amount of protection which is incorporated into this gloves. I mean, there's good amount of protection on your palm as well as on your knuckles as well as on your fingers. Moreover, the quality of material used is great for the price that you pay. You just pay 1600 and you get such a good quality. It's a PU leather with all EBS plastic which is used. I'm not sure which material is used for the protection, but seems to be a very good material. So this is pretty much the review of the gloves, guys. I would rate it 8 out of 10. I pretty much like it for daily city riding and occasional long rides. This would pretty much suit justice. So great gloves done by TVS, well engineered. I mean, they have done a good amount of R&D. So great salute to TVS, and I would rate this gloves 8 out of 10. So that's all for now, guys. Thanks for watching. If you have liked this video, please consider the like button. If you haven't subscribed, do subscribe to my channel.
turn the bell icon, stay notified, and if you have any queries or suggestions, just comment down below and I'll make sure to reply to it. See you guys in the next video.